CompTIA ITF Plus Complete Training Course. Exam Objective 2.7, Explain Basic Networking Concepts. LAN and WAN. Networks of different sizes can be categorized in different ways based on their coverage and scale. In this video, we will cover the most common network types, starting with LAN. LAN is short for Local Area Network and refers to a wired network that covers a small geographical area, typically within a building, small office, or home. In a LAN, devices such as computers, laptops, printers, and servers interconnect, allowing for the sharing of resources, data, and services within the network. In addition to LAN networks, we have WLAN networks. WLAN stands for Wireless Local Area Network. A WLAN is similar to a LAN, but the key difference is the use of wireless technology for connectivity. Instead of relying on physical cables, WLANs use wireless signals, such as Wi-Fi, to connect devices within a localized area. A WLAN may also be connected to a LAN. In this way, a WLAN can extend a LAN by providing a method for wireless devices to connect to and share resources with the wired LAN network. Now we can move on to WANs, or wide area networks. WANs cover a much larger area than LANs or WLANs. A WAN is a network that spans a large geographical area, typically connecting multiple LANs or remote locations. WANs are used to connect networks across cities, countries, or even continents. They enable long-distance communications and data exchanges between geographically dispersed sites. The internet itself can be considered a massive WAN, connecting networks worldwide. And just like LAN has a wireless equivalent, so does WAN. The WAN wireless equivalent is a WWAN. WWAN stands for Wireless Wide Area Network. It refers to a wireless network that provides coverage over a large geographical area, typically larger than what a WLAN can cover. WWANs most commonly use cellular networks, such as 3G, 4G, or 5G, to provide wireless connectivity to devices across wide-ranging areas. A WWAN may also extend a WAN by providing a method for wireless devices to connect to a WAN network. This is accomplished when a WWAN cell tower has a wired connection to a WAN. Now that we understand what a LAN and WAN are, how do they work together? LANs and WANs are interconnected and complementary components of an overall network infrastructure. LANs serve as the foundation for local communication and resource sharing within a limited area, providing fast and efficient connectivity between devices in close proximity. They enable seamless collaboration, file sharing, and access to shared resources within a building, small office, or home. While a WAN extends the reach of LANs by connecting geographically dispersed networks. Together, LANs and WANs create a comprehensive network architecture that enables seamless and scalable communication across both local and global distances. And there you have it. An introduction to LANs, WLANs, WANs, and WWANs, the fundamental network types in computer networking. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more great content.